Hello everyone, and welcome to a Knights of the Old Republic playthrough. I'm pretty excited, so let's just get started right away. So this is going to be a special playthrough. I'm going to be doing blaster pistols only the entire time, which means male scoundrel. And we'll hit up a custom character. I don't really know what portrait I want. I guess I'm always partial to the bald guy, so let's pick on that one. Attributes. Since it's blaster pistol only, the two most important attributes are going to be dexterity and wisdom. And we'll pop those up to 16 for now, and then we'll work on getting those up to 20. Secondary is going to be constitution and charisma, and then there's a few more points I can spend here, so we'll just pop two more in charisma, and since we're going to be playing on hard difficulty, a little bit more in constitution can help out a lot. Now, skills don't really matter that much, so I'll probably just hit it recommended, although treat injury is fairly useful, and I guess I wouldn't really want any security because other characters have security, and this should be good. It's really not that important. Other characters have skills we can use. That's totally fine. Now, since it's blaster pistol only, I really need two of them at once, so I'm going to do ambidexterity, two weapon fighting, and then I only get one feat, so we're looking at other things later, like blaster pistols, and we can get that. Name selection, really doesn't matter here. I like to make a random name every single time, and here's a good one. Two L's. Lane Lanizen. That's okay. That works. And let's start the game. So this game runs off of sort of a Dungeons and Dragons rule set system. So we put points into dexterity because that's what determines how much damage and how often you hit with blaster pistols. No points in strength because there's just, it doesn't do anything for you because that's only for melee exchanges.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time. I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive. Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know all about your reputation. How you used to smuggle spice and blasters along the Corellian run. I guess the Republic figured since they couldn't catch you, they might as well hire you. And I'll admit, the Republic is in desperate need of someone with your kind of skills. Desperate enough to overlook your shady past. And now that you signed on for this mission, you're part of the Republic fleet. And Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Okay, that was Trask. He's going to function as our mentor above the Endar Spire, which is the ship we're on. He told me to put some clothes on that I can get from that locker, and so we'll hit this menu and put the clothes on and, of course, equip a blaster pistol. I want to make sure that I have the difficulty set correctly. Yep, it's on difficult, and we are good. Looking smooth.
Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own. Because of the attack.
And that's basically Trask. It's gonna probably make me, yeah, he's gonna have to switch to party leader to open up this door. Not a problem. And then he's gonna ask to switch back. You can have any character lead, it doesn't really matter. Party members are the crux of this game.
The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
Let's move out. There's a cute little droid doing his best to repair over there. And this door we have to get through using security, because since this is a tutorial level, they make you use skills. Not a problem. Okay, switch to Trask here. Open the door. And now we get to see a lovely cutscene. Cutscenes in this game are kind of weird, but they're still lovable. You can forgive the game for being old, right? Okay, we've got our first encounter. There are two Sith soldiers. We're just going to use the attack command since we're level 1. Going to be doing a lot of missing, but that Sith soldier that just died, I'm pretty sure only has one hit point. So really not a big deal. Both of them got down really easily, and there's usually loot on that Republic soldier that is dead on the ground, but I guess not today. The game decided not to give me any loot today. Really? There's no loot over there? Okay, I guess that's a thing. Let's just move on. Now, in this next room, there are two more soldiers, and I have definitely died in this encounter since they get the first attack off, and you see I'm already at half health. So, gonna use a med pack. Oh my gosh, look how low I am. Come on. Sometimes when you get into an engagement and you're fighting, you can't use a med pack if you already are in the act of doing an attack. And that was an example of that happening right now. We're going to loot the rest of this room. Party members get stuck on you all the time, not to worry. Usually it won't kill you, sometimes it does. It's a little minor irritation. And another fantastic high fidelity cutscene right here. Our friends, the Republic soldiers, got destroyed by the Sith there, but me and Trask, we're gonna mop up these guys no problem. We're gonna make use of a frag grenade. I'm trying to select the middle guy there. There we go. Come on, game. Up. Come on, game. Let me move forward a little bit. There we go. We'll just lob one grenade in there. That'll take care of them. Boom. Easy peasy. One of the things I really like about the combat in this game is that when your character is shooting and he misses, he doesn't just miss, he like shoots the ground in front. Like, it's a potato stormtrooper aim to the maximum degree. And you'll notice there's some feats that I can be using right now, but since you're level 1, I don't want to use feats because a lot of the time they lower your chance to hit even more than it already is. Pretty low right now. It also lowers your defense, and that will increase the AI's chance of hitting you too. And since I've almost already died once, making it easier for the AI to kill me is not really something on my to-do list. We'll loot those guys. We'll loot the supplies in the back corner here. There's an obviously broken door, and we will proceed with the tutorial.
It's a dark Jedi! This fight is too much for us! We better stay back! All we do is get in the way!
Oh,
that was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, they could have used her help.
Now, it would have been super awesome if you could have just walked over there and looted both of their lightsabers and just used it to take down the rest of the ship. But yes, it would also have been totally broken, and we can't do that. Unfortunately, they don't drop lightsabers. So we have to deal with these two ugly-looking Sith soldiers and then not pick up any lightsabers. Disappointing, but that's fine. We can get used to it. A little bit of disappointment. Now, Trask had to walk all the way up there because if the game sort of detects that you can't, don't have line of sight of an enemy, it will force you to walk up to the character, and it's really annoying. Sometimes it gets you killed. Anyway, for this next door, we have to equip a melee weapon, so I'll de-equip the blaster, hopefully for the only time in this game, and head through the door. Since I don't have any strength, this is going to be a bit of a chore, and I might lose a bunch of health. Yep, I am. I'm gonna hit a med pack here. Oh man, okay, he got a level up. So, a mechanic in the level up of this game, after I level this guy up. Once again, skill's not interesting. But once you level up a character, you get full heal, so that's gonna be great. Now, I'm thinking about feats. Conditioning is good, implants is good, the second level of blaster pistol is good, but I think that I want to get, there's a feat called Rapid Shot that gives you an extra attack per round, but it does lower your defense. Won't be using it immediately, but it does come in handy eventually. Trying to decide, yeah, I probably just end up doing Rapid Shot. That's probably the best course of action here, because it gives me sort of an immediate benefit when I do need it. So let's do that. Accept, and as you can see, my character is, ba-bum, fully healed. And we'll continue to use the sword here. I guess I could de-equip it now. Show you some sword animation. Easy game, and we'll instantly de-equip that sword. There we go. Okay, I'm stuck right now. This happens to me sometimes. After combat, you can't move. So to fix that, I usually just save the game and reload it. That happens to me. I don't really know why. Try and find a way to make this not happen, but I think it's just an issue with the game itself. Anyway, after reloading, you can move again, no problem. And for some reason, my sword is still equipped, so let's undo that. And blaster pistol. That was kind of strange. Okay, cool. Everything back to normal. We can continue with the tutorial. Now, this is the bridge of the ship. Nothing really that important here besides some remains. Republic soldiers got massacred, yada yada yada. This is all classic Sith problems. Trask in the way, let's move him out.
Sure.
And we'll enter the next room. We're almost done. Bear with me, still tutorial, almost done with it.
Something behind here. Damn, another Dark Jedi. I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go!
And a classic example of BioWare pulling a fast one on you. That is the last time we'll ever see Trask. Rip, you died. Oh, a good death, soldier.
This is Carth Onassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods. But be careful. There's a Sith patrol just down the corridor. Use your stealth skill to sneak past him.
In classic tutorial fashion, he asked me to use my stealth field generator to take out this guy. But that is entirely unnecessary. I'm strong enough to take down one guy by myself. I've already killed, what, 10, 11, 12 Sith soldiers. No problem. So we'll shoot the ground a little bit. He'll shoot the ground a little bit, but eventually I'll land some shots and take this guy out. Scoundrels have something called sneak attack, and if you are sort of on the side of a character or in the back of a character, you did bonus damage, hit. We'll be making use of that later, but right now, entirely unnecessary. Tutorial level is actually pretty easy. Now, this is another encounter where I've died really easily, so I'll just throw a grenade at this guy to take care of him instantly. One-shot him, and then we can go back to 1v1-ing Sith soldiers, as is our custom. We'll keep shooting the ground. He'll keep missing, and then eventually I'll take him down. It's a rinse, wash, repeat.
There's a whole squad of Sith troopers on the other side of that door. You need to find some way to thin their numbers. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you, if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire security systems against the Sith.
So there's an absolute buttload of soldiers in the next room, and Carr suggests two ways to deal with it. One is to use the repair droid right there, or two is to use computer spikes. Computer spikes are much easier to use because they will just, by overloading the power conduit, as you see there, kill everyone in the room and then give you the experience for everything. If you decide to repair the droid, then you have to go through the engagement, and the droid is kind of garbage. Actually, it's totally garbage. Terrible. It can tank a few hits, but it dies really fast. Otherwise, we'd have to use a frag grenade to get through there. So, overload the conduit. Everyone's gone. There's a red Sith captain. I think he just had a prototype fiber blade.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left.
Which we won't be needing.
You can hide out on the planet below. I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left on the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on! There'll be time for questions later.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the tutorial level. We'll hit up this escape pod and fly off of this burning and destroyed ship down onto the planet of Terris. After all that action, we are now going to get treated to a wonderfully long-winded exposition scene from Karth. So if you've already seen this, and this might be a little boring to you, then you can just enjoy the background music, because I think it's fantastic.
You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever going to wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod, do you remember? I'm not surprised. You took a serious blow to the head. You're probably having all kinds of strange dreams. I wouldn't worry too much about it. You've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. But try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terris. You were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site and all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone. Terris is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet. They've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in our crew. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves. That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Endar Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here in Terris. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her. Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance of the battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never had a chance to use her battle meditation. Like us, she barely got out alive. Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers can use the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. Nobody will be looking for a couple of common soldiers like us. And if we're careful, We can move about the planet without attracting notice. A luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how important she is to the war effort. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help. And we'll probably need hers. Good. We're gonna need to work together if we're gonna survive. While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple escape pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed. Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the Upper City. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. Can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
Oof, I thought he was never gonna shut up. Okay, so we're in the Upper City apartments of Terrace. I'm gonna make sure I have everything equipped. I do. And gonna just go exploring this city, see what we can find outside.
Right, you alien.
Oh yeah. This scene serves to show you how evil and terrible the Sith are. As if you didn't already know that.
That's how we Sith deal with smart-mouthed aliens. Now the rest of you, get up against the wall before I lose my temper again. What's this? Humans hiding out with aliens? They're Republic fugitives! Attack!
Here we get some action to break up the dull monotony of the part gave us. This action is immediately stifled with a grenade. When aliens talk in this game, you can't really understand them at all, so probably just gonna read the subtitle and click through their dialogue. Otherwise it takes way too long to talk with them. Anyway, we'll level up my character, but this episode is rounding out to a close. Remove security, obviously not useful. Treat injury, so it's a weak level up, although the second level is sneak attack. We'll finish looting these guys and hope you enjoyed this episode so far. Should be another one coming out soon. You can bash doors down, but it's based on your strength attribute, and since I have no strength, it's an utter disaster and failure. Alright, well, I will see you next time. Yeah, that's that. Sweet.